midfield. Cade Klubnik and his fellow Clemson Tigers able to put a punctuation exclamation mark at the end of this one.
And with that, I have the Gamecocks going 4-8 with only one conference win.
South Carolina's got real issues.
Leads me to 4-8 for the South Carolina Gamecocks. Now I have...
My bigger takeaway is just Shane Beamer and his demeanor, his makeup. And, you know, you can say that, man, the things that make him so easy to attack when things aren't going well, or the things that make him so lovable and great when things are going well. But that level of unsteadiness and that level of volatility, guys, whether in any walk of life, typically that level of volatility does not play out in a positive way.
Too, when you have, you know, not met the hype that was kind of, there was a lot of South Carolina hype going into 2023. A lot of people had expectations, particularly with how they ended 2022 with the blowout win over Tennessee and with the win over Clemson. There was a lot of energy that was built up, a lot of equity that Shane Beamer had kind of built up. And then, you know, much like Texas Tech, they kind of fall flat in 2023. Now you're really searching for wins on that schedule. And I think the expectations are high because they think, okay, well, we're recruiting at a decent level. We're bringing in transfers at a decent level. You better go out and win.
Since any give up in the locker room?
Hell no.
This is the best environment in all of college football.
Man, I got it. My head melts in my bed.